Well, good morning and welcome to chapel. It's good to see everyone this morning. If you are a visitor here this morning, we do welcome you. A special welcome to Ivan Stevens, an Urban Promise High School student, is here this morning with John. We just want to welcome you. We have a wonderful special relationship with Urban Promise since all of our first-time students do our service learning kickoff day at Urban Promise in Camden, New Jersey. So we welcome you, Ivan. I would also like to thank our community for their generosity during Thanksgiving Chapel a couple of weeks ago, where we collected $356.52 for alumnus Brian Stevenson's Equal Justice Initiative organization. And thanks to my colleague Megan Aceto and our campus ministry leaders for their leadership in this chapel. We appreciate that very much. Since this is our final chapel of the semester, and it also happens to be Christmas chapel, I want to give two early Christmas gifts. First, I want to thank Media Services, Paul Thorpe and Kevin Pawlowski of Media Services, for their commitment and work. And we have a little gift for you that you can pick up after chapel. And we thank you for your dedication each and every week for setting this context up. And also for our chapel student administrator, Sharon McGuire, who has faithfully taken care of the technology this entire semester. I can sleep much better Tuesday evenings knowing that Shannon has all the technology under control. So thank you, Shannon. We have something for you also. So thank you. Each fall semester at our final chapel, we gather together as a community to listen to the Christmas story and to sing Christmas carols together. One specific way we can begin to enter into this Christmas season is to participate in what Christians call Advent, which is the 4 weeks leading up to Christmas. We are grateful to Janelle Spedding of our Academic Operations Division. She has set up for us today from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. in the Baird Library Advent stations that you can just go in, drop in, and take time to pray and to meditate. The word Advent means longing, anticipation, as we wait for the birth of Jesus Christ in our Christian calendar. We also have an Advent devotional for those who would like to really concentrate on prayer and scripture reading during the time of Advent. You could pick one up at the end of chapel. I'm using this just as a guide for each and every day to read scripture and to pray on a specific theme. And also, I need to thank my colleague, Derek Kosovic, music professor, choral director, for putting together this wonderful program. Thank you to the University Choir and Turning Point and the students that bless us with their musical gifts there. Each year, I hope everyone has a bulletin. So everyone have a bulletin, right? If you don't have one of our ushers will get you one, a printed bulletin, and you can see that there are scripture readings in the bulletin, and we are grateful this year. We usually ask a segment of our community to read scripture. We have this year our new initiative called Team Chaplains. Team Chaplains, these are student athletes that serve as team chaplains for each of their teams. And there they are sitting there. And we are grateful to them and for their commitment to the faith formation of the students on their team, and I'm so delighted to work with them. It's a new initiative between athletics and the Office of Faith and Practice. They will be reading in this order. We have William Lowry from our men's lacrosse team, Kirian Yoden from our men's volleyball team, Harper Sellers from our women's field hockey, Rachel Morton from our women's golf team, and lastly, Abby Geisler, also from our women's field hockey team. Why don't you join me in prayer, and then we'll turn it over to the University Choir and Turning Point. Let's pray together. Lord, as we gather this morning, we are grateful to know that we are in a season of anticipation and longing. We ask that you would meet us where we're at, in the dark places as well as the places where we can see light. Help us to be formed into your image and likeness, knowing that you are a God who came to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. And we celebrate that with confidence, hope, and anticipation. We thank you for what you'll do in this chapel and for the readings and the music. We pray all these things in Christ's name. Amen and amen.
For the choir's first song this morning, we'll be singing a song called Cantate Domino. And this is in three languages. It's in English, Latin, and Basque, which is a Spanish language not based on the Romantic and Latin roots. So it's an interesting language, but the translation is sing to the Lord a new song, give praise all the earth. So we hope you enjoy Cantate Domino.
Hello. If everyone be so kind as to join me in reading the scripture in unison. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shone. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end, on the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness. From this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of our Lord hosts will do this. Thank you.
In your programs, on the back, there are lyrics to some of the carols we'll be singing this morning. If they're familiar, wonderful. If not, we have the choir to help lead us. This first one is called Of the Father's Love Begotten. We'll be singing all four verses. I would invite us all to stand as you are able, and we're going to sing this together, Of the Father's Love Begotten. You may be seated. This next song is called The Waiting Sky, performed by our select touring group, Turning Point. This is a perspective of the night of Christ's birth from the perspective of nature, thinking about what the animals were thinking or how the sky was that night or the weather. So just an interesting perspective of the night of Christ's birth. This is called The Waiting Sky.
Oh. the scriptures in the book of John tells us, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Amen.
Please join me in reading Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 35. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, but she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern the sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her,
do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever.
And Mary said to the angel, and the angel answered her,
the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child will be born of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
At this time, we're going to sing another carol together. If you look in your program again on the back, we have the lyrics. We're going to sing, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus. I would once again invite us to stand as you are able, and let's sing together.
Thank you.
be seated.
And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever." Thank you.
Once again, I want to invite us all to sing a carol this morning. So, yes, thank you. Great. Good way to stand. Let's sing, "O Come All Ye Faithful," together, and stand as you are able.
Please join me in reading from Luke chapter 2. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it has been told to them. Thank you.
Your baby boy would save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
last time, I promise. I want to invite us all to sing Joy to the World. Let's stand this morning and sing and proclaim our Lord's glory.
Remain standing for the benediction. Once again, thank you to our university choir and Turning Point for their music. Wonderfully done. Thank you to our team chaplains for the scripture readings this morning. We are grateful for them. And let us not forget the student chaplains who do wonderfully well ushering and giving out bulletins and things. Also, I couldn't help but notice one of our board members is here this morning. Leah Mulhern. So thank you, Leah, for being on our board and being here this morning. And sorry to embarrass you, but Leah is wonderful. Let us pray together. Jesus is the Word made flesh in our midst. May his incarnation fill your hearts this Advent season with joy and peace. Jesus is the promised Savior born of Mary. May his birth among us renew our hope. Jesus is the King of kings and Lord of lords. May the gift of his presence bring forth rejoicing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen and amen.